We're gonna make jalapeno cornbread.
Man, are you serious?
Everybody out there in the world is making liquor out of all kind of stuff anymore. There's a lot of people out there that's like me. They like different. They like some heat and stuff. People make liquor out of all kind of stuff these days. Why not do it out of jalapeno cornbread? It sounds like a winner to me.
You know how I am at the spicy stuff.
Just try it. You know, if we're selling something out there that no one else has for sale, we're ahead of the ball then.
What do you think?
Well,
what is it?
Hot almighty, son. How in the hell can you eat that stuff?
What do you think, though? I mean...
Well, I couldn't taste the cornbread for the hot spicy.
You can't tell me that's too damn hot for you. You know, Jerry's a big old boy now, but when it comes to a pepper or something, he's a damn crybaby. I mean, he can look at damn black pepper in a shaker and go to sweating.
I don't know how you do it, man. You know, when I eat something like a jalapeno, the sensation I get is like somebody's stuck a red hot poker in my mouth. Why would anybody want that in their food or moonshine?
What the hell's wrong with you, Jerry?
My question is, what the hell is wrong with you?
Right, now, look, there's the difference. Our taste profiles are different, but there's a lot of people out there in the world that loves this stuff just like I do. I stand to make a hell of a lot more money on something different like that.
You think we can sell that for more money than we can our rye?
Absolutely.
I don't even know how you'd even mash in jalapeno cornbread.
Make jalapeno cornbread just like right over there, crumble it up, mash it in just like you would corn liquor.
Well, you know that ain't gonna work.
Why?
We can't put them jalapenos in our wooden barrel still.
Oh,
jalapenos is a different kind of flavor. That spicy power it's got, you get that in that wood, you're never getting it out. It'll be in taste in everything we do from now on.
By God, that would happen. We got to find a way, to post-flavor the cornbread liquor after the fact.
Well, I do like the sound of that, because that way we can control how hot it is. The only way we can make this happen is, you know, we're going to have to actually mash in this cornbread, and we'll have to post-flavor it.
Cornbread mash without the jalapenos at first.
We'll flavor it after the fact. You know, that way we got control of how much spice goes in every jar.
The special recipe with the cornbread that I'm making, it's come down from my mom and my grandmother. I'm gonna try to replicate that and do it as close as I can. I've got my skillets greased, a little liquid butter, till that gets hot enough to start frying the bottom of the cornbread. I pour my batter in here, let that cook on the bottom a little bit, let it start bubbling and crisping up around the edges. Then I'll take it and transfer it over to the pellet smoker. That's where we'll finish the process of making the cornbread.
They good smoked cornbread there.
Yeah, buddy. You can't go wrong with smoke, son. There's a difference between a bag of cornmeal and some good old baked cornbread. All your seasonings, your butter, your little bit of sugar, and then of course, you're gonna use a cast iron skillet that's made nothing but cornbread for almost 100 years. How pretty that pound is.
And that's a pound of cornbread.
And there's just nothing like it. Put a little of this melted butter on there.
Mm.
See how that tastes. Yeah, it's gonna be hot now. Damn it.
Mmm.
Tastes like good cornbread, don't it?
Yeah, if we can get that flavor right there and some alcohol, I'll be impressed.
We've got our pounds of cornbread done. We got them smoked, cooked, baked. We're ready to go mash these things in. Heck yes, that's a good clean barrel. Let's get this stuff out of here and start crumbling it up. What do you think? Well, this is a pound of cornbread, and this is what we're mashing in. We're just hoping to bring this flavor out of this cornbread into our clear jar of liquor, and then sooner or later, of course, infuse it with a little bit of jalapeno flavor. It's gonna taste a whole lot different than regular corn shine. It's gonna be good, my bud. We're just gonna crumble them up, put them in the barrel, stir them in with hot water and sugar, fill it up, yeast it in, and hope it does its thing. All right, we'll lay the sugar to it. I mean, it smells just like Granny baking cornbread with the kitchen window open, with the wind blowing in the evening, man. This stuff is going all through the woods. It smells so delicious.
Well, this is your idea. I'll let you sauce it up here.
I'll sauce it up, brother. I don't mind one bit. Now all we gotta do is just pitch our yeast and let this stuff work off and come back in here in a few days and get ready to run it off. Looky there.
It's flat, ain't it?
Good boy.
Mmm. Son, that cornbread taste is there.
Boy, I can get me a damn jar of that. Let's pump it over, man. I'm ready to fire this bad boy up. You see the cornbread floating in there? It's worked off, it's ready to rock and roll. We just gotta pump it over, fire this thing up and see what we get.
Drop her in.
There it flies. With the end result, we want to do a jalapeno cornbread. So we got to run this off, get some good cornbread liquor, and then start post-flavoring our jalapenos.
You know, adding jalapenos and stuff in, that's gonna be a whole nother trial there, you know. Jerry don't seem to be so...
optimistic about it.
Optimistic about how the damn world we're overflowing.
Well, I'm gonna fill these pellets up.
You got her full?
Yep, I got her full.
All right, there she flies. Feels good to be back over here in Tennessee burning this old barrel, don't it? It burns good, but one damn thing about it, I can't stand how long it takes to heat this barrel up. We're gonna be here half the damn night on this.
You know, we need to just hurry up and wait. Well, we're definitely moonshining under the moonlight tonight, ain't we?
Yeah. Damn, she's getting warm right up in here, brother.
Yep. You done our money pop there. What kind of crazy nuthead do you think's gonna buy something like this?
Somebody nuts like me.
I hope you're right. Because if we ruin this good liquor with all that jalapeno spicy junk, I'm gonna be upset.
Come on, man. You know, there's more stuff in life than damn sugar and sweet cakes.
Well, I understand that, but you ain't gotta hurt to eat.
Well, I don't hurt when I eat.
So when you cry and your face turns red,
no, it feels good to
gag and carry on. That ain't hurting.
I love to hurt and burn like that and cry.
You'll fit perfectly in hell, won't you?
I'll kick the devil out, son.
Yeah. Son, I'm telling you what, a little pat of butter, and son, you'd be on the table.
Oh my gosh, son, that's good stuff.
That's really good, man. You can taste that crust, that smoky pecan wood we put in there.
It's in there, ain't it? Now the only damn thing, Jerry, since we got such good cornbread liquor.
Yeah.
I just got to figure out how we're going to extract and post-flavor this cornbread liquor with the jalapenos. We took fresh jalapenos, dried them out, going to grind them up.
We're just grinding up into a powder. It's a lot easier for the alcohol to break down the powder than it would be just a full piece of pepper.
Smell that. Mm-mm. Think you're a wolf of it.
I don't think so. I know what that's... Yeah, we got our peppers ground down, and basically our high proof will dump right in on the powder. Make a tincture, we're gonna add it back to our alcohol. So that's why we're using the high proof alcohol to actually start that process out.
Lock that damn steel up, son.
Turn the hose on.
We've done a lot of runs in our time, but we've never been able to actually look inside the steel itself.
Pretty cool. I've never get to actually watch alcohol boil like that.
We're just looking for a subtle note of jalapeno flavor with a little warmth of the throat and finish with that sweet cornbread on the back. Ooh. There we go.
There we are.
We made it, brother. We got her going. We're just gonna let that fill up and let that stuff start extracting out. You know, stir it up, stir it around, get that good color, and we'll strain it. If I just ground all these peppers up into a powder and started mixing it in my alcohol, yes, you'd have that flavor, but you're gonna have all these floaties and all these particles into your alcohol that you don't need.
Oh, that's some green goodness there.
The Green Goblin. It's the fuzz now. Ooh.
Okay, well that face, I damn sure ain't trying it.
It feels like Yeller Jackets in your mouth, but it's got a phenomenal flavor. I'm gonna do a lie.
Whoa,
hell.
What are you doing?
Listen to me now.
Oh my God.
We gotta make
it. I can see that clear to the bottom now.
Well, you gotta see it. Yeah. She's right now.
Too much, huh?
No. Now, by God, that's right. What the hell's wrong with you?
Right.
Hell yeah, that's right for me.
No, dude, that's wrong,
Jerry,
what that is.
No. You know, subtle jalapeno flavor is a lot different with me than it is Jerry. One dropperful to each jar is perfect. But there's a lot of people out there in the world like me. They're gonna want this stuff.
Man, I'm behind you. You know, you say you can sell it.
I can do it, brother.
You know, I'm right there behind you to do it.
I tell you what, this stuff has turned out phenomenally. It's at the right balance of heat and taste on the jalapeno and the cornbread. You can taste all notes coming through each jar of this stuff. I'm gonna find us a buyer and we'll make money, baby. Jalapeno cornbread. It's going out the door, I promise you.